the social life at that time was generally centered around families, and that she no longer has. She was well acquainted with the emotions now. What do the lonely do at Christmas? I'm trying to figure it out. I'm all by myself. At least I can cook for my son, but now he's gone. She's economically needy now, because when a husband dies, it is the wife and the children who bond together and keep the family business going. It's their job to pull together and work and struggle and pull together and work the farm. It's their job to plow. It's their job to get together and plant. It's their job to come together and gather harvest. But she had only one son. Lord, have mercy. And the scripture refers to him as a young man. We're somewhere around verse 14. The scripture says that he was a young man. And so it is in the Greek now, in the young man and his age, located him between 24 and 40 years old. Lord, have mercy. But with no son and with no family, a widow was left to the charitable impulses of the community. Lord have mercy. You know, when you become a charity case, people seem to forget that you're human. They want to give you stuff that they don't want. They want to put clothes in a trash bag that they didn't even wash and give it to you and treat you like a dog. See, this woman was left to the impulses of the community. No social security, no SSI, no community welfare, no food stamps. And she was thrown, the Bible says, by a group of mourners who was there, some of them there to be nosy. And I'll bring you a cake on Saturday, honey, and I'll bring you some chicken on Saturday, but after that, this don't stop me, because I gotta have my own chicken. I gotta have my own cake for my own chicken. This woman was needed. We know things like that after the repast, that's just about it. You don't even hear from them no more. And all in all, this lady burying her boy was like she was burying herself. And I'm in the midst of people tonight who are socially needy, because everybody in your faith five got more issues than you can deal with at this time. Is there anybody who can talk to me for me and look at me and see where I am? Look, it's written all over my face. You don't have to say a word. Is there anybody who can talk to me? Lord, have mercy for me. I know a clock's walked in the door tonight. It's just the night of the living dead, because you're economically needed now, because that dead-end job has no promotion in sight for you. The boss don't even recognize the extra things that you do to keep the company going. I know I'm in the midst of some people who came here tonight, and you just the dead among the living. Lord, have mercy. The dead among, I ain't say the living among the dead, I say the dead among the living, because it seems like everybody else is moving and everybody else is mobile and everybody else got things going on, but it seems like every time I take two steps forward, I get pushed. Lord, have mercy. I know it, I know it. You wonder if God is even talking anymore. You wonder if God is even... anymore. How you walked in here, I see the cook right now. I ain't gonna look in your direction, I just see it.